the regular.
Regular, okay.
Yeah.
Hampton is a place with kind of what a lot of people would think to be a dull scene, quiet life, happy people, but a lot of the time they don't realize what really goes on in the town's youth. And one of the things that happens with the town's youth is the local musical.
Just some information that she's going to pass out to you. And I'll go over it really quickly so that you can get on with your read-through.
If anybody wants a full company photo, so be ready in just a few moments while I have this cleared for you. Three things, I'm sorry, before we begin. Student directors, would you please hand...
Yeah.
Do you want to ask me? I'm okay with things.
You and I talked with things.
I'm the student director.
That way it'll just be easier.
My name is Ben.
Also,
I have a real quick serious thing to say before we do this.
Technical director is Mr. Halter. He and I have been doing shows here since 1997. In any capacity. So, student director, we have her. We have student vocal director, Leah McConnell.
Yeah!
And we have student choreographer.
She's in front of you.
Just right there.
None of us were paying attention. And then when the show was happening, we were like, what is this about? I'm like outing myself here to everyone right now. I was a terrible person. Anyway, we were like, what is this show about? What are we doing? Like, when does this happen? We had no idea.
You'll have a job. And then this is the troop ad-libbing. Yeah, what are we gonna do? Where will this all overlap? Where will you find out?
What's your favorite thing about the read-through so far?
Read-through? I think I always like just seeing all the interest for musical. After the like past few years, interest in musical has like been going down a little bit, so seeing everyone together again is really great, and it looks like we have a lot of new underclassmen, which I'm really excited about.
Quiet down.
I'll take care of it. Come back tomorrow and we'll have a new idea.
Got any...
auditions to evaluate us for possible lead roles. We just got done singing all of the songs and we're going to be moving on to the acting portion of it pretty soon. Yeah, so essentially for the preliminary audition round, the directors will pull excerpts from other shows, but callback specifically are for people that they want to see more of, and so they find material that's straight from that, like the musical that we're doing, which this year is something wrong. And they will film us. They will film us, your films, but they will basically judge us based on certain excerpts that they want us to see, based on like what character they think would fit each person.
And they're not looking for perfection, they're just looking to see if you would fit best in that role, and oftentimes they're looking for chemistry and different parts of...
Potential areas of...
Of the things that they can work on while still making it the best it could possibly be.
And Andrew's going to always sing a female role.
Yeah.
Today is the first day of rehearsals.
Yes, it is. And that day would happen to be January 4th, 2023.
Right, and what do you like about today, specifically?
That it's the first day of rehearsals on January 4th, 2023.
My favorite part about like first day rehearsals, though, is you get to see what people have been working on since we got our parts and stuff, and it's really cool to see it all come together.
And there's all this like excitement, you know, you jump back in. Like we did stuff before break, but now we're
anything you hate?
Well, I haven't been able to go on stage, and I'm probably not going to be there right now. And there's a lot of anticipation on whether or not I can do this stuff. So that's good.
Yeah, I'm probably taking it, but there's definitely a lot of nervousness as you have to think about, like, you get ready to be like, I need to know everything.
Yeah.
Especially when you have people like that doing it so good.
Okay, so think about a couple of lines. They can be to one another. Let's get a little tighter. Again, she's probably going to have you in some sort of memory. Not sure where we were going.
Because I say,
sorry. Yeah, I don't know where she's going.
Keegan, you just got a director's prize. What did you get?
I got a relatively good condition blue TI-83 cowboy. And I think for me, that genuinely might be one of the best director's prizes that has ever been given in my presence.
It actually works.
Because it's functional and useful. And that's saying something.
Right.
Because other people received empty plastic bags.
So what did you think about like the whole director's prize system? Was it like, was it weird? Was it like, what was it?
You, like in general or today?
Today.
I was honored. That's all I can say. They're basically always like that though. We want to take not good prizes, but it's not about the prize. It's about the recognition.
Yes. Like what kind of thing do these kind of rehearsals do for everyone involved? Like, how do they improve?
Well, it's a building process, right? This is our very first one, and they come into this knowing that they have to be off book already, so that that way when they're up there, they don't have the script in their hands, and I can see them more as a full actor and see how they're engaging and working with one another. And every time we run it, it just gets a little tighter, and you start to pick up on little things they're doing. You're like, yes, keep that, or don't keep that, or speed this up or change this.
Mm-hmm.
We're layering as we're going, right?
Right.
And then we polish.
Right.
And, so that's what these do. And it's nice to, for them to bond.
Right.
So.
Yeah.
Oh, sorry. Well, hello, my name is Kai Soyama. I play Nick Bottom in the show.
I'm Isaac Thatcher. I play Nigel Bottom. And, we are brothers in the show.
Yeah.
And today we're doing an interview.
We're on dinner break right now. We just came from an acting rehearsal. We have a vocal rehearsal in a few minutes. So I think as far as our dynamic goes on stage, I find it pretty interesting that this is your first year acting, right? Like, let alone not even the private in a musical.
It is my first year.
It's pretty song and dance intensive. So I think you, like, hit the ground running. I think you've been great so far. We have this chemistry, and I was not expecting that, but I think we work really well together. It's just really unfortunate that I'm this short, this that tall, and there's a clear height differential, and I'm supposed to be playing the older brother. So I make up for it here, I think.
I do think that adds to the comedy, though. The height difference being so immense.
Did you have to, like, slouch you, like, literally have to bend down and speak to me? It feels so condescending sometimes. And when I hug you, like, around the shoulders, I have to, like, feel my tippy toes, but
it's still good. Oh, it's, yes. I think it just adds to the comedic element, because this whole show is about comedy, so...
And we're both in our element, I think, with our respective characters. I am supposed to play this very boisterous, charismatic character. You're a bit more shy, a bit more timid, but you're the brains behind the operation, so you're really the one pulling the strings. So I just think our dynamic is going to work really well together, and I'm really looking forward to a phenomenal
presentation. Okay, today's date is January 18th, 2023. 3 months and 3 days out from opening night. Today's our first full cast acting rehearsal, so we're working on the full cast scenes and getting everything placed. It can be a pretty tedious process at times, but once everything clicks, it's really effective. So it's a really exciting time.
Yeah. Is the time when we should...
Yeah. So same thing.
Just make sure that the fall is like...
Nah, go subtle.
You're not bracing.
Subtle's better.
You're
yeah.
both not.
That's almost like hitting the
audience. Because you don't have to go in the same place.
Right,
you can take the energy
and
make your
erection.
You cannot provide such ungodly erection.
So you're not bracing for anything. At the very least, you should go like this instead of this because you're not going to be face to face.
As a magistrate, I have much influence with the Master of the Justice.
So
you really want that guy giving a speech at your wedding reception? Let not thy sacred soul be poisoned by the poets and playwrights. Whose dark invention seeks to divert simple minds from the one true book.
Okay, so I mean that's usually what we start with today is doing some power tools training. You guys aren't going to be using much of it today. What I'm going to do today is kind of talk you through what we're going to be doing, and then we're going to clean up the stage a little bit.
How many different set pieces? With nine, yes, there are nine different set pieces, really, with our main set piece. And as you guys probably know, there's going to be two-sided set pieces.
We're not worried about that.
We could just go back and pretend like we cleaned.
We did clean. We cleaned up the gels.
We cleaned up one thing.
This is theirs. That's their problem.
Hair and makeup.
Crew right now, which are pretty chaotic because everybody's cutting a bunch of pieces for something that they really don't have a visual for yet, although we do have plans and we have a visual. It's really hard to see when you're just measuring out a bunch of pieces of wood and trying to put them together. So that's what they're doing over here on the floor. They're trying to measure, do what we call cut lists, which then will be put together to create the set pieces down the road, but right now, yeah, it's very chaotic because we really don't have a vision of what we're building. We're just cutting a bunch of lumber.
Measuring! Yippee!
Okay, what's this 10 foot?
What?
What's this 10 foot?
First time doing like
no this
second
year. Musical third
show
last year.
And do you like the process and stuff?
It's interesting.
Yeah.
It's a good process, but yeah,
it's a lot.
It's good. It's
but
good.
Like, do you learn like skills that you thought you'd never have?
No.
That's different for person. For me, I sort of knew what I was doing before I came to crew.
Fair enough.
Okay, well, I guess if you're thinking that way, then yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, ba-da, ba-di. da 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 da. Let's go right up. No, no, no. 17. 1, 2, 3, ba. 1, 2, 3, ba. 1, 2, ba. Yada. And we're swinging, right? So this is round 17, please. 17. 1, 2. Ready. Go. 3.
Outside of her, so.
How are we feeling?
So I'm feeling pretty good. It's a little stressful. We're in like the middle of the room.
Where's my bed?
Not someone on you, but mine is.
Yeah, for sure. And what's the date today?
February 25th.
And what are we doing today?
Today we are learning some partnering sections for the song It's a Musical.
And what are you most looking forward to in the show?
I'm most looking forward to all the tapping we get to do. I'm very excited.
And we're only about a month and a half away. What's most nerve-wracking, but what's most exciting about being so close to the actual performance?
Most nerve-wracking would probably be the fact that we are a month and a half away. And I'm most excited for just getting to perform with everyone and having a great time on stage.
You done? You done?
Yeah.
What are you guys doing today?
We're paneling. I don't even know what this is, but we're paneling.
It's the back of the back wall.
Oh, look, it's
right
back
there.
Wall. Where does it
How
go?
Did you not know that?
Where on the back, back wall. Wall.
Which back wall?
This back
this
wall.
This one that we literally just drove it to.
The back wall.
Wait, it's so we're gonna go in front of it?
Yeah.
Oh, it is? Wall.
Are we on the steady pace for doing it?
We seem to be on a pretty good steady pace.
I'm pretty happy with our progress.
Okay, and do you think we'll get everything done before?
I think once we get all these big set pieces, then we have a lot of work, a lot more work than we think we do.
Honestly, that might be the
the dimensions of those are, but the thin ones we use for trim, it'll be like two side ones, one on top, one on the bottom, one in the middle, for so you have something to nail them into, sort of, just like the clips in the open. Not actually, yeah.
Remarkably, they won't think that. Seriously, and why not? Because it's a musical, a musical, and nothing's as amazing as a musical, with song and dance, and sweet romance, and happy endings happening by happenstance. Bright lights, stage fights, and a dazzling chorus. You wanna be great, then you gotta create a musical. I don't know.
Please.
Claire Camel.
And what's your role in the musical?
So I am the head student costumer, and I play my violin.
Perfect. And what have you guys been doing in costume for the past few weeks?
So far, some of our main goals have been to get lots of the troop outfits and the Puritan outfits put together. So this morning we cut out all the fabric to make 10 of the Puritan capes. And the past couple weeks before that, we've been cutting out and sewing the troop outfits.
Perfect. And what are you looking forward to most for the show?
Oh, my favorite part of the show is always costumes parade, whenever I get to see the cast, see their costumes.
We are at rehearsal. We are getting mic'd.
It has like three different sizes.
By the lovely sound people, Claire and Melanie. They're great. And but I have to kneel down because I'm too tall when they mic me, but it's okay. And today we're going to go over some dance numbers with the pit, the live orchestra, so that's very exciting. And we're gonna tap dance, and we're gonna be so such a great time.
And if she is, can you send her over here?
Oh, we should have had a guest of Franklin in.
Pardon!
So this is the Pit Orchestra. A lot of great people here. We love all of them because they're just so great. I can introduce you to a few of them. This is Claire. Claire plays
the violin.
The violin, and she's super good, and we love her.
Thanks, Isaac.
And then there's Paige, who plays the
also the violin.
Also the violin. And then
hey.
God. This is Lucas. He plays the flute. And then Jason plays the trumpet. And Enrique plays the guitar. And Anna plays the piano. We have a lot of great pit members.
Defendants, let them get to their space. 1, 2, 3. I sentence you to be banished. Taken on the first trip to the new world. Oh, and take your so-called
Miles.
Miles. So how do you feel about all the chaos going on today with the three groups here?
Yeah, I mean, I think it really describes musical theater in general, because it's like you have so many people here and they're all doing like really different jobs, and I think it really shows that it's not just the actors on stage, but it's everyone that's really combining to make this amazing production. So break a leg, everybody.
So I'm here with...
I have an Oasis.
And you are... like the principal trumpet of the pit, yes?
Yeah, I'm also a
Yeah, Johnny, I can see one of the types ever.
Nice, nice. And what is today? What's going on today?
So, that you would like genuinely give birth to. It's great.
You know, no, not because he looks like a woman,
dressed like Mr. Meyer.
He just like literally
kind of looks like Mr. Meyer.
You know what I mean?
It's the best I can do.
Right. It's pretty cool, yeah. Going up.
He's going up. If Jacob dies on the lift, how are you gonna end it? Are we gonna make it look cool? Is it gonna be like circus music? Like,
tell me when.
I don't know
how my
brother
And with all the sawdust on the stage, I like have way better traction, so I'm actually able to move without
kind of fall on your butt.
Without the the urge to just the feeling that I'm just gonna like slip and fall at any given moment. It's great. I love the traction.
Very cool.
He's better. Although I probably will need actual boots or jazz shoes of some kind for the show. Okay. I'm not sure if I'm actually.
Yeah.
I'm not sure if I'll be needing those
at
all. At the very least, tap shoes.
At least tap shoes, tap covers.
They haven't really addressed that yet.
No, you don't
need figure that out.
Because you're already tapping the top off, right?
Yeah, but for the scene preceding that, I don't know if I'll have to take them off.
Well, there's a way you can walk, like, on your tattoos without it making noise.
Yeah, but, when you do it, it's weird. Cause you're, like,
it is weird, because I end up looking like...
It's weird. No, like because this. you have the metal covers on the tops and the bottoms of the shoes. How do you walk in such a way that you don't make any noise when you're on stage?
What Caitlin told me to do, because put this on the record, David. Caitlin Howe, resident expert tapper, she was like... She was like, walk like this with your heels up, and then it won't make noise. So I listened to her, but then I started like walking like this on stage. So we're gonna see how that goes before opening. I might need tap covers.
Yes, we will. You might. I don't know at what point you would take them off to make it seamless. I mean, it might, but I guess that's something that we work on now at this stage in the production. It's exactly what rehearsals are for.
We
know how to overcome these kinds of issues. We're not open to that. We are no stranger to everything coming together last week.
When you come on stage for this part, hey, everyone should be listening. When you come on stage for this part, straight lines, please, okay? I know from what I saw, because I was looking back, even though I'm not supposed to do that, no lines were straight. Use your peripheral vision. I can see everyone, I can literally see, like, everyone behind me right now. It's like a prison for it, but use your peripheral vision, even if you have to, like, a little bit. Just make straight lines, please.
Today, this morning, I watched progress being made in these choreo numbers. So many problems seemed that even from the last time we ran them, huge improvements. Today was not one of the, please don't take this the wrong way. It's one of the first times I was watching this where I'm like, oh, I can't wait to see this. Right? It's not that up until now you were doing something terrible, but this morning you stepped over a threshold in places.
Anxiety was kind of outweighing the excitement factor.
For a while, and you know, understandably, because as LaBella said earlier, this is a giant show. Technically, costume-wise, I don't know if we even started with that yet. I know some of you have like 5 or 6 pieces. So it's huge, and you've heard me say this before, Woods was nothing like this, nothing.
That's like comfortably within your range.
Sorry, I don't know if it's
a cop. I'm just honest. You guys are doing so good. Now take it up.
Yeah.
up higher if you can.
After Hard to Be the Bard is this scene, and we walk in and do like its egg and stuff. And I need to change from this into my troop outfit.
Yeah, I can help you.
You look bonita, love. You look quite good, man. Quite. I love to read more.
Interviews. Got a pose for a portrait and how a deplore sitting there for eternity. Then it's off to the inn where my innkeeper friend wants to name a drink after me. Then it's back to my room while I resume my attempt to write a hit. Just me and my beer and the terrible fear that...
Go to 21 again. Here we go, 21.
Did I miss my cue?
Robin, what are you wearing? This is a dress rehearsal.
Oh, I thought it might help me get into character, you know, if I were to wear dresses and go to taverns and flirt with men, you know, for research.
Nick, I have...
So I'm with Claire again. Claire, how do you feel about the fact that we now have to call in cast members to help with the crew since there's so many big set changes and important movements in this musical?
Well, I think it just kind of speaks to the nature of kind of what musical is. Like, we put so much of an emphasis on this place being a family. And for me personally, like, I'm in the costumes crew and I'm in the pit, and oftentimes if I need help in costumes, I will sometimes grab some pit members who aren't really doing too many things, and they're more than happy to help me out. And I feel like the cast is doing the same thing with performance crew with their set pieces. So it really, I think, just kind of speaks to how we are all one unit.
Every time I'm here, just stay in here. And at 7 o'clock, we'll come and do our pre-show meeting. And then at 7:25, your stage manager will call places and so on and so forth. So this is not really that sort of meeting. We just want everybody to get used to coming here at 7, and that's it. We'll cover everything else tomorrow. Remember, you do have live albeit probably sleeping bodies in the house tonight. I don't know how many. We just opened house in Kalamazoo. Please don't forget, if you want to usher, we could use 4 ushers per night. It could be from any of our domains, the orchestra, the cast, or crew. That starts at 7 and goes until, you know, curtain at 7:30. So any one night you do it. I don't want somebody to have to do it twice, but we do need ushers. So if you could volunteer one night, yes, that would mean that you're missing this meeting. But we don't have an organization to cover that for. So if you would want to give up some time, that half hour.
It's the only time you get to be out there in costume. So.
Let Meg know, please, because we could use people, right? Come see her before you leave here, if that's something.
I already have 7 lovely people who have volunteered to do it.
Fantastic. That's what's happening. Yeah, I'm finding more than one.
Same. I'll do it. Like, Meg,
I'm texting you right now. And then what I'll do, Meg and I will walk you through that each night before 7 o'clock out there as to what you do. Right? It's super easy.
And a bit.
The person that's injured, we certainly want them to be part of it, right? We hate when we have to pull that away, but ultimately when it comes down to it, you have to think of that person's health first and foremost. And that's always going to take priority. So you kind of have to put on the back burner the effects of the show and put the actor, the person first.
Perfect, thank you. How's the muffin?
Oh, it's really good.
What's the muffin?
Zucchini pumpkin, I think.
It's like zucchini pumpkin and
something. Did you make them?
No, I did not. I just heard what was in them like 10
minutes
ago. Indeed.
It's so good, actually.
It's really also, good.
No, my hands are like really sticky and I don't know how I'm going to wash them. It's going to be great.
Thank you.
Bye.
Sure.
Yeah.
That, we love a good cheap on it.
My quote for the night is Shakespeare in As You Like It says, "The fool doth think he is wise, but the wise man knows he is a fool." And you are all wise fools. And let me tell you what, as I have watched this show, I mean, when we work backstage, we don't really, we know the show, I've read it, but over the last couple nights, I'm laughing nonstop. And you guys are just bringing it to life. And I just realized today, this is my 20th musical on the stage. Cool. Are all wise fools too, and it's been just such a pleasure to watch your personalities open up over the last couple months. So yeah, break a leg, it's going to be fantastic, and in 20 years, I don't ever remember the Thursday night senior crowd getting on their feet.
No.
So you brought up the feet last night, they liked it, so it's going to be amazing.
I am so happy for all of you to be able to come together like this. I'm so proud of all of you and what you have accomplished up now. I am in awe of all of you and how you are working together. Look around at the number of students that are in here. For a small district like this, to have this many students dedicated to an event that is so specified, it's a really amazing thing. And you all come from different walks, from different areas, from different specialties. You all bring different things to this show to make it a cohesive piece of living art. That is hard to do. Really hard to do. And from what I've seen so far, you are knocking it out of the park. As Mr. Halter said, you never see a standing O during final dress from the senior citizens. It's late, they're tired, they want to go home. But you got it. One of those, we have some faculty who retired a number of years ago. They came last night and they were with one of the office secretaries. And so I wanted to pick her brain this morning about what she said, or to get her feedback, and she said, that show was fantastic, I'm going to be telling everybody about it, but that first number, oh my God. She said that number just like sucks you in and tells you right from the start the kind of ride that you're in for. And she said the energy, just everything about it, she said, I just bought in right off the bat. And that's because of what you guys brought to the table. How the cues were synced up, how the music was played, the moves that were performed to the beats and all in unison. I mean, my God, it's a hell of a show. I'm excited for you to be able to do this, to really add this last layer. You had a little bit of it last night, you had that taste, but this is the true one, right? This is the one where you might have heard some giggles last night. You're gonna hear some laughs tonight. You're going to hear them, and it's going to drive you, it's going to feed you. At this point, you and the audience become symbiotic. You're working together to have a fantastic evening and a wonderful time. So enjoy yourselves tonight. Ms. Prone, I'm going to steal your line, break eggs. Speaking of producer tasks I have to do throughout the next couple performances, my job is done. So it is now at this time that I am no longer your director. I'm turning the show over to our stage manager, Emma Ahn. Would you please call places?
Places in 8. That was to the second.
Wow.
Thank you.
Oh, I would like to start off. I would like to start off that Shane has to bend down to be at height level with me, which he could clearly just stand up.
It's okay.
But
how are you guys?
I'm gonna go on my tippy toes.
How are you guys feeling about opening night?
I'm so excited for opening night. Yesterday went really well for final dress, and tonight is just
we're
gonna
do
it all.
We should be.
I have not seen the show yet.
I'm very nervous.
And I'm excited.
Why?
There is no pita bread.
Where's the pita bread?
I'm not stressed. What? Like, I'm going to be so real. I'm not stressed whatsoever.
I know how many costumes I fixed yesterday.
Just, I mean, costume-wise, but like actual screw-up wise.
To point the camera.
So.
Absolutely.
Welcome to the Renaissance, the 16th century experience. In an age that's golden, the olden days are over.
Yeah, okay.
All right, Daniel. How are you feeling opening night?
I am, like, okay, it started off as excitement, but now since we're, like, an hour, maybe an hour and a half out, it's turning into a little bit of, like, nervous energy. I'm not gonna lie. However, then I think about September, auditions, rehearsals, how long it's been on the kick line of a musical, and just, like, everything that we've been through up until this point, and I realized that this show is going to be amazing. It's just like, I mean, with a cast like this, it's incredible. I mean, this show is, I think, it feels like not real, almost like a movie. It's incredible.
So tonight is opening night, obviously. Wow. And so are the seats sold out now?
All right, so so we closed the online sales like around like 4:45, right? That way, we have some to sell at the door. When they closed the online sales today, there were 250 some seats still available for people just walking in. We will probably sell those, usually, or at least close to it. So we're getting close.
But what about those seats? You know, when you set that thing on Dan, those were like the pre-seats.
Those are the pre ones. So those you know everybody can buy online any day of the performance up till 4:45, and then like that online window closes.
So did we sell out of those?
Well, it's like the whole auditorium. You know,
yeah.
We can pick where they
okay.
Want. So we haven't sold out of anything yet, but I think we're gonna see a really packed house tonight.
And how are you feeling yourself with the whole culmination of everything we've done this year?
You know, it's funny because this year we did more rehearsal nights till 10 than we usually do. We had almost 3 full weeks of nights till 10. Usually it's 2. So I think everybody right now is more tired than they normally are. But always, I wake up the morning of opening night. Doesn't matter how little sleep I've gotten, I am just super excited to get here and just get the people in the seats. And get to hear their reaction and share what's been basically going on since September. Share it with everyone. It's an awesome feeling.
Yeah. Yeah. Isaac, it's second night. How do you feel?
Pretty okay. Last night went well. Hoping for an even better time tonight and a bigger audience. Yesterday's audience was pretty big for opening night, but we're hoping for an even bigger audience. And I'm pretty tired. But I'll get more energized as we continue with the show.
Did you guys get enough sleep last night?
Yeah, even though I got to bed at like 1:30, it's fine.
Why was it 1:30?
Because we all went out to Applebee's, and it took them really long to get us all food, so I was just there until like 1 or something.
Ghost! The Phantom! He is the former king who was murdered by the prince's uncle. And the uncle's name is... Scar! Scar. And he murdered the king.
I'm also thinking we're more than likely going to have to hold until like 7:35.
737 9133.
How are we? Okay, guys, why don't you all get in for
get it?
This?
So it's not just...
How are we feeling? Like, it's the third show, Asia and Brooks. It's almost the last show.
Okay.
We couldn't say that's
actually
tomorrow.
That's actually not relevant,
so,
like, at all right now.
I'm excited because if enough people walk in, like, and buy tickets at the door, it's perfect. We're gonna sell out
it's
for
really
the first
exciting.
Time in 10 years, according to
really?
I think. Hey.
I'm a little spooked. It's been a week since we've done it in front of an audience. Not a week yet.
But you're gonna do absolutely well.
Yeah, you are.
Yeah.
So like,
yeah.
It's actually
I love the affirmations, guys.
Yeah, we're going to do great. We're going to do great.
What about you, Kai?
It's gonna be great.
How are you feeling? Almost last show.
Well, I'm feeling great. I feel like this is my first show where the excitement trumps the nervousness.
For
I think
sure.
this is a show that I've actually been like looking forward to performing, as opposed to like just being like frightened out of my skin to put on again. And I think that just stands a testament to how much fun we're having with it and how great of a job everybody's done so far.
And Nathan, first like your being character, how do you?
It's fun, it's terrifying, and I sit backstage and I go through all the lyrics because I'm afraid that I'm gonna miss them.
I have messed
them. That was
them
me
up.
Last year.
Really?
It was actually like horrible. I would go backstage and I would go through the entire song multiple times, trying to convince myself that I didn't know the lyrics. But I
last year
the lyrics.
To find safe to.
What are you talking about?
For Woods, like trying to get the order of all the to blank, to blank to blank to
oh,
blank.
Oh yeah.
Or do you remember that time when Andrew?
When he just started scatting because he completely
in a show.
In a show.
I
keep on screwing up the one line in the reprise, and it's I on Wednesday I hit it.
On Wednesday you got the.
I lost sight of all that matters somehow.
I lost myself.
I lost myself, and I now did this. No. That's literally like verbatim. Like
I did not see it then, but I see me now.
It's okay. The audience is not thinking that much about it.
I don't think they even watched it, so they wouldn't know if you missed it.
Dull and mundane, that was so Middle Ages.
that was so Charlemagne. Welcome to.
Yeah, this looks so good. I was like, oh,
I saw it.
Odds are I'm going to be an emotional wreck, like, a lot of people, but I guess, like, if I had to say a few things, the freshman class, one, like, the most mature, hardworking freshman classes I've ever seen, the sophomore class, when they become juniors next year, they're going to do some great things, junior class, they're going to be, you know, just a crucial part next year, and I know as a senior, it's going to be really weird, like, not performing with Kai again, not performing with, like, AJ again, or Andrew, Isaac, Liam, Marissa, like, so, Leah, so many names, you know, like, not performing with any of them again, not doing a Dan Franklin show again, that's weird. One piece of advice, though, that I would say, like, really stuck with me was sophomore year. Is before the preview show for Pippin, and I went up to Franklin, and I was like, I've never performed in front of a high school crowd before. Like, do you have any advice for me? And he asked me if I ever saw Transformers, and I said yes. And he said, treat the crowd like it's your Energon cube. So if I had to leave with any parting words, I will leave with Dan Franklin's parting words. I think, I don't know, I think I've said enough sappy things. So.
I got close to
you. Have spent the last 4 years as our family. We are a family. You've probably spent time with everybody in this room far more than you've seen your own siblings and parents awake over the past couple weeks. And it's these kind of experiences when you all come from individual backgrounds and you build something this beautiful together, and you share it with the public, with the world, that bonds you.
I really appreciate that you jumped in this year to help me out. Everybody knows probably that I don't love leading warm-ups, so that's something that my student choreographers have kind of jumped in and do, and I really appreciate that you do that. I super appreciate even more so that you help me see it. It's perfect, and thank goodness the two of you have really run it and made it to what it is today, because it's a phenomenal show visually, and that's because of all of your hard work. So thank you, Madison.
That was so sharp.
the glowing gators bar to box. And every minstrel's control the streets of blood.
There she is! You dare defy me, Daughter of Eve!
Oh, please, Father!
You bid me grant you leave so you can pray forgiveness in church, and instead you slither off here to sate your lustful desires!
Oh, Rant!
Damn, you did awesome.
Thank you! So yeah, this is why we're meant for this stage.
So the real bits are on stage in the thing.
Okay.
Watch out.
All right, guys, we're at strike.
Yeah.
It's very sad. A couple weeks after musical descended, how are you guys feeling?
I'm feeling like I have no idea what I'm doing.
The disassembly of the set is actually an analogy for how my life is falling apart right now. It's an allegory for my emotional state.
It represents the world falling apart.
I just say though, it's one thing ending the shows, and then another actually like tearing down the set and seeing how barren.
Legitimately, it actually is, because it's like been that way before.
His crew built a literal village, in which there are functioning houses that you can be in them. Yeah, so it's just as cumbersome as it was incredible, and just having to take all that down, it really hits different. But it's not over yet. We still have one more performance.
So true. Not on this stage. Not on this set,
but it's very, very exciting. So we're still more than ecstatic for that.
Cool.
School being over.
It's a shame. I have nothing to do for the next couple months now. Literally nothing.
Hello.
I'm with Melanie. Melanie, how do you feel that the musical has finally come to an end?
I'm sad. I'm sad about it because we're taking apart all of our stuff that we worked on since January in like a couple hours. But it's bittersweet. I don't know. We had a good run. I'll be back next year. I don't know, I'm just... Yeah, it's pretty sweet.
Go see a musical. A musical. All of the dialogue is sung in a very dramatic fashion.
Really?
Yes, really.
There's no
talking. And they often stay on one note for a very long time. So that's when they change to a different note, you notice. And it's supposed to create a dramatic effect. But mostly you just sit there asking yourself, why aren't they talking? I believe it's pronounced miserable.
What? And people actually like this?
No.
They love it! And what's not to love? It's such a delight, it's not the quite like a musical.